Hey there, history enthusiasts. Welcome to the mesmerizing world of ancient narratives. If you have a passion for enthralling tales, brace yourselves for a journey through the most inspiring fictional stories from times long past. Through these stories, we are reminded that life is a series of trials and tribulations, and success rarely comes without struggle. They encourage us to face our own struggles head on, turning adversity into an opportunity for growth and transformation. Inspirational stories teach us to embrace failures as stepping stones towards success and to find strength within ourselves when it seems the world is against us. Without wasting any time, let's get into the first story. Do you know how hunters of old used to trap monkeys? A man asked his child. Rather than chasing them up a tree or shooting arrows from below, they'd put a heavy glass jar with a narrow neck on the floor, which had the monkey's favorite food inside. They'd then step back and hide, waiting for the unsuspecting animal to approach. When it did, the monkey would reach inside, clench a fist around the food, and try to pull it out. However, the narrow neck of the jar would stop the poor monkey from getting its hand out. It'd pull and pull, but to no avail. There was simply no way to get its hand out of the jar without releasing the food. Rather than letting go, though, the monkey would persevere, refusing to drop its dinner. The hunters would then approach and catch it to enjoy a meal of their own. "Don't be like that monkey," warned a man. "In life, to fight another day and grow as a person, you must know when to quit, when to move on, and when to let go of whatever's holding you back." Moral of the story: sometimes you have to let go and give up what you have now to receive something better in the future. Don't let stubbornness be your downfall. At the beginning of a new school year, a class teacher stands up in front of her students holding a $100 bill. She tells them, "Put your hands up if you want this money." Every hand in the room goes up, to which the teacher says, "I am going to give this money to someone here, but first, let me do this." She takes the bill and crumples it up in her hands before asking who still wants it. The hands stay up. The teacher then drops the bill on the floor, stomps and grinds it into the ground, and picks it back up. "How about now?" she asks again. The hands stay up. "Class, I hope you see the lesson here. It didn't matter what I did to this money, you still wanted it because its value stayed the same. Even with its creases and dirtiness, it's still worth $100. She continues, "It's the same with us. There will be similar times in your life when you're dropped, bruised, and muddied. Yet no matter what happens, you never lose your value." Moral of the story: life's hardships are inevitable and we'll all be put through the ringer at some point, often through no fault of our own. Don't let these challenges alter your feelings of self-worth. You'll always be enough. You have something unique and special to give and offer to the world. An old Cherokee chief sat down to teach his grandson about life. "There's a fight going on inside me," he tells the young boy, "a fight between two wolves. One wolf is evil. It's full of malice, anger, greed, self-pity, and false pride. The other is good. It's full of peace, love, joy, kindness, and humility. This same fight is going on inside you and everyone else on the face of the earth." The grandson was quiet, pondering this revelation for a moment before asking, "Grandfather, which wolf will win?" The old man smiled and replied, "The one you feed." Moral of the story. Good and evil exist within each of us. It's our responsibility to own that reality and do whatever we can to nurture the good. One morning, an elderly man was walking along the beach when he noticed a young boy picking something off the sand and throwing it into the sea. As he got closer, the man realized the child was throwing stranded starfishes that had washed up on the shore back into the breaking waves. Approaching the boy, the man asked what he was doing. "The starfish will die if they're still on the shore when the sun rises," he replied, perplexed. The old man said, "But that's pointless. There are countless miles of beach and thousands of starfish. It doesn't matter how many you return to the water. You can't make a difference." Unfazed, the boy bent down, picked up another starfish, and tossed it into the sea. "It matters to this one," he said. Moral of the story: no matter the odds of success or the skill of the challenge, your actions can make a difference. It's better to light a candle than curse the dark. Every little one counts. Doing something to make a positive change is always better than nothing. One day, a man walked past a camp of elephants. Looking closer, he was surprised to see that these mighty animals weren't held in cages or kept in chains. The only thing stopping them from escaping, a thin rope was tied from one of their legs to a simple pole in the ground. Confused as to why they didn't use their strength to break the rope, he asked the trainer why they weren't attempting to run away. To this, the trainer replied, "As baby elephants, we use the same system. But at that age, the rope is strong enough to stop them from escaping. They grow up like this, believing they can never break the rope, so even as adults they stay put." In other words, these powerful, magnificent, and intelligent elephants didn't believe they could free themselves, so they never tried. Moral of the story: our personal beliefs are powerful boon measure and often dictate our outcomes. They can work for or against us. Once upon a time, there was a businessman who was sitting on the beach in a small Italian village. As he sat, taking a brief break from the stress of his daily schedule, he saw a fisherman rowing a small boat back into the harbor. In the boat were a few large fish. Impressed, the businessman asked a fisherman, "How long does it take you to catch so many fish?" To which he replied, "Oh, not so long." The businessman was confused. "Why don't you fish for longer to catch even more?" "More. This is enough to feed my entire family and even offer some to my neighbors," the fisherman said. "So what do you do for the rest of your day?" inquired the businessman. The fisherman replied, "Well, I usually have caught my fish by late morning, at which point I go home, meet my wife, and play with my kids. In the afternoon, I take a nap and read. In the evening, I go to the village to have a drink with my friends, play guitar, sing, and dance into the night." Putting his entrepreneurial hat on, the businessman offered a suggestion. "I have a PhD in business. I can help you become much more successful. From now on, you should spend longer at sea and catch as many fish as possible. When you've saved enough money, buy a bigger boat to catch even more fish. From there, you'll soon be able to buy more boats, set up your own company, build a production plant to can the fish and control distribution, and move to the city to control your other branches." To this, the fisherman asks, "And after that?" The businessman laughs. "After that, you'll be able to live like a king. Take your company public, float your shares, and be rich. After that, you can retire, move to a house by the sea, wake up early in the morning to go fishing, then return home to play with your kids, spend time with your wife, take a nap in the afternoon, and join your friends in the village to drink. Play guitar and dance into the night. Puzzled, the fisherman replies, "But isn't that what I'm doing already?" Moral of the story: be content with what you have. Do you need to keep pushing for more? Stress is often a choice. There's joy and peace in simplicity. A long time ago, a baker and a farmer lived in the same small English village. These two men had a friendly arrangement in place, where the farmer would sell a pound of butter to the baker each day. One morning, the baker decided to weigh the butter to see if he'd received the correct amount. To his surprise, he discovered that the farmer had sold him less butter than he'd paid for. Angry about the unfairness, he took the farmer to court. At the hearing, the judge asked the farmer whether he used any measure to weigh the butter. "Your Honor, I am but a lowly farmer and do not own a proper measure. I simply use an old-fashioned scale," he replied. "How do you weigh the butter then?" inquired the judge. To this, the farmer answered, "Your Honor, long before the baker started buying butter from my farm, I've been buying a pound loaf of bread from him. Every day when he brings me the bread, I place it on my scale and give him the same weight in butter. If anyone is to be blamed, it's the baker." Moral of the story: be kind and fair to others and you'll enjoy the rewards. I saw my life branching out before me like the green fig tree in the story. From the tip of every branch, like a fat purple fig, a wonderful future beckoned and winked. One fig was a husband and a happy home and children, and another fig was a famous poet, and another fig was a brilliant professor, and another fig was E.G., the amazing editor, and another fig was Europe and Africa and South America, and another fig was Constantine and Socrates and Attila and a pack of other lovers with queer names and offbeat professions, and another fig was an Olympic lady crew champion, and blonde, and above these figs were many more figs I couldn't quite make out. I saw myself sitting in the crotch of this fig tree, starving to death, just because I couldn't make up my mind which of the figs I would choose. I wanted every one of them, but choosing one meant losing all the rest, and, as I sat there, unable to decide, the figs began to wrinkle and go black, and, one by one, they plopped to the ground at my feet. Moral of the story: decide. Take action. There's no right or wrong answer when you're choosing between two positive routes or outcomes. Wait too long, and the decision will be made for you. There was once a group of 100 people attending a seminar on personal development. In the middle of their talk, the speaker stops and decides to run an impromptu group activity. He hands out a balloon to each attendee and tells them to write their name on it. The balloons are then collected and placed in an adjacent room. The speaker then instructs the 100 attendees to enter that room and, within 5 short minutes, find the balloon with their name on it. Pandemonium breaks loose as they charge in, pushing and colliding with each other as they desperately search for their name. The 5 minutes pass and nobody succeeds. The speaker then tells each person to pick up any random balloon and give it to the person whose name is written on it. Within a few minutes, everyone has their balloon back. He then said, "What just happened with those balloons is exactly what happens in our search for happiness. We frantically look for it all around us, not knowing where it is. Yet our happiness lies in the happiness of others. By giving them their happiness, you get yours." Moral of the story: happiness and fulfillment rarely come from selfish pursuits, but almost always come from doing good deeds for others. By helping others, we help ourselves. In ancient times, there was a queen who ordered her soldiers to maneuver a boulder into the middle of the main road to and from town. The queen then hid, watching to see who would stop to do the right thing and move out of the way again. Wealthy merchants and courtiers passed the boulder, barely giving it a second thought. A few of them blamed their queen for not keeping the roads clear. Yet none stopped to do anything. One day, a peasant walked along with a sack of vegetables to sell at the market. He stopped, laid these down, and then pushed, tugged, huffed, and heaved the stone away. Upon picking up his vegetables, the peasant saw a large purse full of gold and a handwritten note from the queen herself where the boulder had been. The gold was a reward for whoever removed it from the road. Moral of the story: laziness will never get you anywhere in life. Success almost always takes humility and hard work. As we reach the end of our journey through the captivating ancient narratives, we hope you've enjoyed these 10 inspirational fictional stories from the depths of history. If you found yourself enchanted by these timeless sagas and eager for more, remember to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. Don't miss out on future expeditions into the wondrous realms of antiquity and the allure of ancient narratives. Join our ever-growing community of history enthusiasts and let's keep unearthing the treasures.